guys, welcome back to my channel, or welcome to my channel if you are new here. It is no secret that I have a shopping problem. So today I'm gonna share a little haul, a huge haul, of random things I've been buying. I have clothes, home decor, some beauty items, I have new perfumes, just lots of things to share with y'all. Everything will be linked down below that I can find, and you should definitely follow me on Instagram. I was doing like a ton of different updates there and all that good stuff. So definitely follow me there if you haven't already. Subscribe if you haven't already, and let me know what videos you want to see on my channel this summer. Oh my goodness, it's almost summer, which means I'm so close to my due date. It's so crazy. Oh, I also have baby stuff to show you. So yeah, let's go ahead and jump into it. Y'all, I've never been more excited for a sponsorship in my life, because as soon as I opened this package, I was instantly like so impressed. So let me start from the beginning. Today's video is in collaboration with Dozier Perfumes. If you're new to my channel, like, you don't know my love and appreciation for Dozier, because I love their perfumes. They are a perfume and cologne company. They make luxury perfumes actually accessible. They have no luxury markups. They have 100% free returns. If you don't like one of their perfumes, you can easily return or exchange it. And they have the best scents inspired by super expensive designer perfumes. So this month I hit the jackpot and I got three scents that are also amazing. I don't even know how to decide which one's my favorite, so let me show you. The first one I wanted immediately after I saw it on their Instagram is this one. This one is called Woody Sandalwood, and it's actually a dupe for the Le Labo Santal 33 perfume. It is such an expensive and like wanted perfume, and I've never tried it, but y'all, this smells heavenly. It's very nice and musky, but so like sexy. It's actually unisex, so I could totally see a guy also wearing this, but it's not too masculine either. It just smells mysterious and like, it's just so delicious. I cannot explain it. It's like spicy but musky but kind of sweet at the same time. So well balanced. I think that's my number one thing with Dozier. It's like their perfumes are so well balanced and they all smell so good. I'll show you my little collection. I have so many, and every single time they do not disappoint. And the next one is this one. This one is the Floriental Cedarwood. This one just sounded like a dream, like the perfect balance between like floral, sweet, and kind of like woody. I would definitely wear this more in the nighttime though. And this one is also one of my favorites. This is the Oriental Cherry. I've never had a perfume that smells like this. It's so unique and freaking delicious. This one is very nice and sweet, perfect for summer. It's very nice and fruity and floral. I'm just obsessed. I cannot say enough good things about Dozier. Definitely check them out with the link down below. They have great discount codes, and you can use my code to get 10% off on top of their discount. If you don't follow me on Instagram, I showed y'all my evil eye nails. I basically did this like on a whim. I was bored one night and I was like, let me just try nail art out. And I think it turned out super cute. The base is dip powder and then the evil eye is gel. So the base looks kind of wonky, but I think they look adorable. So on that note, y'all know I'm obsessed with evil eye stuff because of my grandma. So I picked up two things that are evil eye jewelry. The first thing is this little tiny dainty ring that has evil eyes all over from none other than TJ Maxx. $14, 14K gold. Highly recommend. It's still in stock. They have like happy faces and hearts. They have super cute rings. And then this is from ASOS. I don't know how long this is gonna last because it's like not gold plated or anything, but it was like $9 and it's like a little, okay, my hand is so embarrassing. It's like an evil eye choker thing. It's so cute. So if you're also obsessed with evil eye stuff, I'm actually surprised I haven't bought any Amazon jewelry lately, but those are such a steal. I don't know how to explain myself on this. For some reason, maybe it's just because I'm gaining weight because of my bump, I don't know, but I live in Houston and it's about to get like scorching hot here, and the only thing I can buy for some reason is sweatshirts. Like, I have such a big collection. I do not need any more. I go on websites and immediately gravitate towards sweatshirts. So this one that I'm wearing is actually from Poshmark, but I bought a ton from ASOS. So I got this one from Adidas that I thought was so cute. This is actually very oversized. I got a size medium. This fits like an extra large. It's super long and boxy, so I might return this for a smaller size. I thought this would be really cute eventually with a little tennis skirt, so I got that. I got this one from ASOS as well. They're all from ASOS. It says Amore. I thought this was precious, and I got a size US 8. Once again, nice and boxy and oversized. These are just so comfy with biker shorts. And honestly, y'all, I'm about to hit my third trimester. I don't think I'm gonna be leaving my house much. So that's the only way I can justify this. I got a few sweaters, randomly enough. They're from their plus size collection. This one is definitely very big, so this one is getting returned, but I thought it was so cute and preppy, and I love the color combo. This one though, I'm definitely keeping. I'm obsessed with it, and it's a US 14, which is like the smallest size of their plus size. This fits like a large, so if you're plus size, maybe size up a lot. But this is what it looks like. It's kind of like a little cropped knit sweater, and it just has a smiley face. I thought it was adorable. And lastly, very similar to that Adidas sweatshirt, I got this one. This one is like a quarter of the price, maybe less than 30, and the Adidas one is $70, so go for this one instead. It's a hoodie though, and I got this one a size large. I need to stop buying sweaters. That is my conclusion. But I actually did a no buy for clothes, so these are actually from the last month. May is like my clothes like no buy, because I had too many clothes. I sold a ton of on Poshmark, and now I really just want to get stuff that is comfortable for the third trimester and things that I can transition like out of my pregnancy as well. Like, I don't want to buy a ton of clothes that I can no longer use. So yeah, that is all the clothes I got from ASOS. So next up, I have kind of like a huge beauty haul. So think like a Sephora meets Ulta. This website looked fantastic. Send me a ton of things. They have stuff from like the drugstore, like Maybelline for example, but they also have like higher end brands like Olaplex and things like that. So I picked up a few things. So I tried a few of them to give you a quick review. The first thing I tried is this Isle of Paradise self-tanning butter. This was all the rage last summer with the bloggers, and I never really tried it. I've tried their self-tanning drops, and I really like them. They do kind of break me out and give me some texture, so I definitely want to try different ones. So if you have any recs, let me know. But this is nice. I used it last night, and I definitely have like a little bit of a glow. It's very nice and moisturizing, and it absorbs pretty quickly. I will say this is very warm toned, and it will probably won't work if you're like tanner, like if you're like a darker skin tone, because I don't think this is dark enough. But since I'm super pale, it gave me like a nice little golden glow. It is very warm tone, like I said, so maybe go for something more olive or violet if you're not into kind of like the orangey tones. On that note, if you like a super dark self-tanner mousse, this thing is intense. So I mostly bought this because like in the summer when I start going like in the beach and the pool and I get a little bit of color, my self-tanners don't really do much for me. And this one is the Saint-Tropez Extra Dark. And that might scare you looking at my skin tone right now, but once I get a little bit of color, this is actually perfect. So if you are tanner than me, darker than me, this might work really well for you. I will say this is intense. I wouldn't leave it on for more than 3 hours personally, but it's a great self-tanner, definitely worth the money. I usually love this brand Way. They have really good hair products. My favorite is the beach spray and also the leave-in conditioner or something, because of the scent. It smells so good, and they usually work really well. So I picked up this set. This is for medium hair, and they also have fine hair and thicker hair. I just went for the medium hair. I used this for the first time yesterday. My hair is like straight right now. It's okay. I don't think I can like judge a shampoo and conditioner just after one use, but I will say I was kind of disappointed that the scent isn't like their usual scent. It doesn't smell bad by any means, like it actually smells pretty good. I don't know how to describe that scent, but I do prefer their regular scents. This is more like a unisex scent in my opinion, but it's pretty good. So far, so good. I will definitely update y'all if I like it in a future favorites video. Then I picked up two makeup products. The first one I've been using for a while. This is the Nude Sticks Lip and Cheek. Wow, can I speak English? Pencil in the shade Mystic. It is the perfect, like, your lips but better, or like my lip color but better. And it's such a nice formula. It is pretty pricey for like what you get, but you can definitely sharpen this, and the formula is just so nice and buttery without being sticky or like too slippery. I love this. Such a great color. And then I got a mascara from The Balm. I used to own so many things by The Balm, and then I completely forgot about it, but they sell a ton of things there. So I got the Matte Lash Black Mascara, and I used it today for the first time, and honestly I'm kind of underwhelmed for like a higher end mascara. It kind of did nothing for me. Oh my god, make sure to wash your hands if you use that self tanning butter, because that's embarrassing. But anyway, this is what the little one looks like. I don't know why it won't focus. It didn't really elongate them or do anything special, so I would like pass on this. This was one of the first things I added to cart and Look Fantastic, because I was in desperate need of an eye cream. This is by Ren Skincare, and this is a brightening dark circle eye cream. I used this for the first time last night, and I was kind of like disappointed at how tiny it is, but it is eye cream, so you need the smallest amount. And I love how it's an airless pump inside, so you don't like miss any product. But y'all, instantly I saw like this brightening effect under my eyes, and I was shook. So I'm gonna keep using it, see if it really helps long term with my dark circles. I think with skincare it's just important to like really use it consistently and see if it actually works, instead of like a one-time thing, because most things like don't really work that well the first time. So I was impressed, but I will definitely update y'all in an updated skincare routine. And then the last two things I picked up from Look Fantastic are, well, is this set of makeup brushes by Real Techniques. I just thought they had like cool like little sets. So this one comes with a blush, foundation, shadow and highlighter and concealer brushes, and also like their little sponge. I used this one today to blend out my like bronzer and blush, and then I used this one for concealer. They're pretty good. If you know Real Techniques, they make really good quality brushes, and I think this was less than 20 bucks, so great value. Then I saw that they sold Sol de Janeiro, and I usually love their stuff. I love their scent, but I picked up this new kind of like body spray. It's a Brazilian Crush 71 Caramelized Vanilla and Macadamia perfume. I don't know if I'm used to like dosier perfumes, just like how well balanced they are, but this is so freaking sweet. I cannot stand it. I like sprayed a little bit on my arm and I could smell it throughout the day. I had to take a shower because it was so like overly sweet. So I'm gonna have to pass on this one. I think their like regular scent, it's just so much better. So I have a ton of baby clothes. I've been accumulating this for a little bit. My favorite place by far to shop for baby clothes is H&M. They have the best prices, always 20% off discount codes, and they have a lot of like range of sizing, and the quality is just great. So a few things to show you. Got this cute little neutral set. This is literally like 2 to 4 months, but to me this looks teeny tiny. It also came with some pants. How cute. Then I got a ton of these zip up kind of onesies. I thought, well, I did a video a while ago sharing like some Shein finds before I even knew I was having a girl, and so many of you were like, yeah, you're definitely a first time parent, that's a lot of buttons. So I decided to just get a ton of zipper things to make my life easier. So these are 2 to 4 months. They came in this like very nice neutral pack, which I love, which means I can use it for a future boy. This is actually from TJ Maxx, and it is just such a cute little like sleep sack. Look at the cute little giraffes. This was only $9. I don't shop there a ton. Honestly, she has a ton of clothes, so I don't really need to be buying more. I got these kind of like a cumulative order, if you will. This is from H&M. Look how precious. I can't handle it. It's just so cute. It's a two-piece outfit. This one is 12 months. Wow, that's crazy. This tiny little thing was like $5 maybe, and it is also 12 months, but this can be a dress or a top. Then more of those. These are newborn sizing. So this one came with like a yellow, a pink that I have right here. Look at that, so small. And then the floral one, super affordable. And then this one is also from TJ Maxx. Pretty sure Dante got this one. This is 0 to 3 months, so newborn. This one was only $7, and I could not resist this. I know this is huge. I think this is probably what, 1.5 to 2 years, yeah, but it's so cute. So I'm trying to buy different like sizing for her, that way she has like a ton of clothes. But tell me this isn't the most adorable overalls you've ever seen. I definitely need to make a part two on just like home decor, because I have so many things coming. But I stopped by Hobby Lobby the other day. They got rid of their 40% off coupon, which is kind of rude. But they had everything tabletop 50% off. So got this super cute little picture frame. I just love it. I think it's adorable. And I printed out a ton of pictures. So I just put this one from our gender reveal. And then I picked up two little, I think these are called vases. I don't really know. For some reason, I want to call them jugs, but they don't have a handle. So this one kind of gave me like Restoration Hardware vibes. And then this one is the same tone, but a different shape. So I put these in my little like bookcase that I have in my office now. And they're adorable. So they were like $17.99. Wow, that's a lot of money, but they were 50% off. So I didn't realize they were so expensive. That's kind of a lot. And then the hidden gem is buying books, like coffee table books and just books in general, from tjmaxx.com and marshalls.com. Y'all, I found so many good ones. I have a ton coming. I have the one from Louis Vuitton, and I have the Architectural Digest book as well. But I got this huge book, and it's so beautifully shot. Let me show you. Look at that, stunning, and so affordable compared to like Amazon. Even like, I don't know, they have books that like Serena and Lily sell and things like that for like over 70% off. So if you're looking for like good coffee table books, check TJ Maxx and check Marshalls. So guys, that's everything I have for you today. Definitely a little bit of a shopping addiction. That's why I had to do a no buy for clothes this month, because I was out of control. So I definitely think I'm gonna be shopping a whole lot more. We still have a ton to do, like with the baby, the nursery, the house. I have a lot of like home items coming that have been kind of delayed because, you know, the furniture delays right now are crazy. So definitely stay tuned. Let me know if you want to see a part two of this video, because I definitely have some packages coming and I would love to share with y'all. Thank you to Dozier for sponsoring today's video. Definitely check them out down below. I swear to God, these perfumes are some of my favorite of all time. Like, I would rather use these than like super expensive ones. So highly, highly recommend, if you've never tried them, to do so already, because so many of you have done it and y'all love them as much as I do. So definitely check them out. And yeah, follow me on Instagram, subscribe so you don't miss out for more videos, and I'll talk to you guys in the next one.